have two guests. Our topic is Diaspora University Town. They will introduce themselves and take off. Let's start with my right hand.
Thank you. My name is Dan Kamau. I'm the Executive Trustee of Diaspora University Trust and Project Director of Diaspora University Town.
Thank you, viewers. My name is Ronald Mangombe, Executive Director, Dara B Company.
Dan, jobs creation has become the 2022 political discussion. Diaspora University Town signed along Voitaveta Roads to advance Kenya constitution rights, housing, healthcare, education through jobs creation. How does jobs creation advance constitutional rights?
Thank you. Diaspora Kenyans today achieve their constitutional rights of healthcare, housing, education, and even children rights and other social rights through jobs created abroad. When people work productively, they produce these rights for themselves and their children through the jobs that through work and jobs. The DUT Master Development Plan, which we also call the DUT MDP, is currently Kenya shillings 130 billion plan that will create 20,000 jobs through the systems, plans, and technologies that will be enacted at Diaspora University Town.
Ronald, the Diaspora University Town sign at the road reads, project by the Dara B community, Diaspora Kenyans and partners. How did the Dara B community become part of this jobs creation project?
Okay, thank you. I'll first thank God for blessing our community with this project. Dara B community is settled in the Sagala Hills and the plains in the northern side, that is also part of the Voi town. In 2016, Bishop Mawasi, who lives in Atlanta City in the US and whose origin is in Taita Taveta, came with the plan of the project. The plan was already passed by Taita Taveta County Assembly. The plan required land to build a university town, and Dara B had an idle land. After reading the plan and discussing with the bishop, God blessed us with the project, and every day we continue to be blessed by this project.
How is the community being blessed?
We just held a community AGM on 24th February of this year, 2022, that over 1,000 members attended. Unlike previous AGM meetings that did not have a goal, this meeting goal was to advance the project. We talked on how we shall progress the project, the projects we shall start in order to support the project with materials, water, and other products as we create jobs. Since 2016, over 500 persons who were children have since turned 18 years and became adults. We are happy to hear songs like Diaspora Job Kazi from the young people in our community as they start creating their careers of entertainment. The meeting discussions was about the work that is started and shall be done this year, and even the money that that shall flow into our pockets.
Okay, Dan, looking at where you are today, is the DUT project success?
The project is a success. We today have Diaspora Kenyans and Dara B community creating and progressing the next model of economic, social, and environmental developments that meet constitutional rights. The DUT Master Development Plan, DUT MDP model, is for making resources productive to benefit those whose resources are applied productively. Diaspora resource of money is being applied to the project. Last year, diaspora remittances reached Kenya shillings 400 billion. Over 70% of this amount went towards consumption, and it did not enter in the side of production. This is what we want to start entering in the production so that we can meet those rights. The second resource that we are applying is the diaspora intellect. Right now, we have the medicine and vaccines plant by scientists. We have scholars in diaspora who are coming to set up the university. We have persons in the healthcare field, doctors, nurses, who are coming to set up the Diaspora University Hospital. So that's another success. Diaspora, the Darabi community is a land resource, is today being made productive. And as Ronald has stated, they are now looking at materials that they will supply the project with. The other success in the project is also the Darabi community members who have started working. Their human resource is now becoming productive. So the project is a success.
Ronald, is DUT a project success?
Yes, it is. Before 2016, I would never have imagined that our community could produce and sell products worth 10 billion. Today, I'm working on the Darabi campaign plan that will extract mine and farm products from our land to produce over 20 building materials and farm products to sell to the Diaspora University Town project and our community.
Dan, how will this model benefit other parts of Kenya?
The model will help Kenyans understand how to apply their resources of diaspora cash, diaspora and Kenyans intellect, land and human resources productively. With the community, we have started the DUT credit. The DUT MDP model will be part of growing the Kenya bank deposits to reach Kenya shillings 12 trillion and loan advances to reach Kenya shillings 10 trillion by 2030. The model will be taught at Diaspora University. Students will be empowered to go create new jobs and develop houses as Kenya population grows to 60 million and the workforce of those aged 18 years to 65 grows to 30 million.
Okay, Ronald, year 2030, where do you see Darabi?
By 2030, the company that is Darabi company will become a major supplier of building materials and other industrial products. The SGR goes through our community, and in 2030, I look forward to having Darabi company dispatch 50 containers of our product through the SGR.
Thank you, guests, for your time. This was Rangire TV. Until we meet here again, God bless you.